With an overcrowded jail, more inmates are being released to a neighborhood near you. While they're being watched, deputies are outnumbered. As one family tragically discovered, a pair of scissors freed a man from house arrest and sent him on the prowl for an 8-year-old boy.
It devastated us all.
It was a crime of opportunity. A man who cut off his electronic monitoring bracelet on the run for 16 days.
There was never a warrant filed for his arrest.
He was captured on this store surveillance video just minutes before he raped an 8-year-old boy inside this Value City restroom.
And then he yelled, "Mommy," and jumped my arms and said somebody hurt him.
Today, Sean Zimmerman is in prison, designated a sexual predator, his victim now 17, and the boy's mother concerned that this bracelet isn't enough to keep criminals from striking again.
Don't fool yourself. You're not safe.
I actually recall being out looking for Sean and not being able to find him. We didn't have the technology. Now we have the technology, but we don't have the manpower.
Brian Hale is one of only 8 deputies in Hamilton County's electronic monitoring division.
Hey, what's going on?
With hundreds of people on house arrest, deputies are outnumbered.
Yeah, we're stretched very thin. We're sitting on a powder keg. I'm nervous 24 hours a day.
Unless you look at their ankles, you'd never know these people are on house arrest.
They live in your neighborhood. They live in Hyde Park. They live in Over the Rhine. They live in Sims Township. They live in Green Township. They live all over.
And Big Brother is watching them. As their ankle bracelets send a signal to satellites, they're being tracked by computers downtown at Hamilton County's Electronic Monitoring Division.
So we know where people are on a perpetual basis, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Deputy Hale and partner Adam Wong spend their days and often nights making surprise house calls.
Blow real hard, a straight, solid, steady stream through until I'll tell you good.
On this program, you're not allowed to have alcohol, drugs, or weapons.
They test us daily.
Okay, you have the right to remain silent.
Karen Grant of Hartwell and Zachary Wagner of Delhi are testing the limits of home incarceration.
You got the spoons, Eric?
Deputies discover Karen's been smoking crack. Zachary's been smoking pot.
You told me there's nothing illegal in your house, but downstairs we found some stems and we found some seeds.
Both are headed to jail. Both will be back out within hours.
Show this unit out. Reference a felony warrant service.
On this day, deputies have gotten an alert that Mark Irvin has cut off his bracelet. That bracelet is sending a GPS signal from inside this house.
So I don't know if he's going to hide or if he's going to try and run. If he's even in fact here, because he has cut the band.
Irvin is awaiting trial on a felony drug offense and has a lengthy rap sheet that includes abductions, stalking, drug trafficking, and drug abuse.
We know they have a gun because there's a gunshot in that window back there.
Deputies often don't know what kind of danger is behind the door. Assault rifles, machine guns, knives, crossbows, samurai swords, even this hand grenade, all found in homes of Hamilton County residents on house arrest.
Very dangerous, extremely dangerous. We have a number of people that have, you know, are on for, on bond for aggravated murder, felonious assault, rape, crimes against children.
Hamilton County Sheriff's Department, is anyone here?
On this day, no sign of Mark Irvin.
How much of a cat and mouse game is this for you?
This can be very much a cat and mouse game.
After 4 days on the run, Mark Irvin is picked up and back in an overcrowded jail.
That pushes more people to us, and that pushes more violent people out in the community.
9 years after her son was raped, this mother is still concerned. With a shortage of manpower and monitoring equipment, she fears there will be more cases like Sean Zimmerman if something isn't done soon.
There will be. I know there will be. There's just no stopping it.
The Sheriff's Department took over electronic monitoring 2 years ago, and there's an 85% compliance rate among those wearing bracelets. But the division is in need of more deputies and equipment. While hundreds of people are on house arrest, only 60 GPS units are available, and without GPS, it's difficult to track these folks when they leave their homes. Dave Wagner, Target 5.